My name is John McAvoy, and I'm a movement ecologist. We are in Myanmar, and we are here on our Asian elephant GPS tracking program. It's really quite incredible that the Asian elephant, if you look at where it lives and where humans live, the most densely populated parts of the world, and yet we know comparatively little about them. We are trying to collar elephants to learn very basic stuff about their movement. We want to know where and when and how they move around the landscape. All of that basic ecology can be learned from tracking the elephants. We have been collaring elephants with GPS trackers since 2014. We're hoping to put on an extra 15 collars this year.
These collars will give a GPS location every hour throughout the night and day for the next 2 years. These collars are expensive, but the data that we get from them is priceless.
The bigger spread we can get and the more areas we can collar the elephants, the more questions we can answer. The habitat is being lost. Their populations are going down very, very rapidly. They're not very easy to find on foot. Our trackers have to spend hours and hours in the bush. The mahouts, they spend their whole lives around elephants, working with elephants. A lot of these mahouts are similar in age to the elephants that they work with, and they form quite a strong bond with their elephants. And it's really that knowledge that helps them find elephants. It's why they can find them so much quicker and so much better than we can. There seems to be a number of them have crossed here very recently. You can see the vegetation and the footprints, and that trail just right here, you can see all the broken vegetation. They're likely to be pretty close.
Dr. Zhou and his team are preparing the tranquilizer dart so that we can safely approach and collar the elephant.
We'll let them go ahead a little bit, and then we're going to follow after them and try to keep as close as we can. Often when they take a route, they'll break some branches very obviously for us to be able to see where to go. We're just looking for those signs.
I'm already thinking of what this is going to tell us and what we're going to learn from this elephant.
213 centimeters.
We've been working on a mobile app collection system where our data collectors can go out with a phone in their hand. They can go to a site, and as soon as they come back into an area that has either phone signal or Wi-Fi, all of that data is immediately sent to me back in the United States. This will really take our data collection just another step forward and streamline everything. All of that information has already been sent. It's currently saved on our servers.
We reckon he's about 15.
They
have to maintain
it
by
himself.
Okay.
Later
in half hours.
Will the Mahouts stay nearby to see?
We will see another little far away. Yeah. How about the elephant? If the elephant can get it, we'll leave.
Okay. Trying to pick up the VHF beacon from the elephant that we just collared to see that it's working, and we can hear it quite well. The GPS collars really have taken things a big step forward in our knowledge, because we can put a collar on and we can follow an animal for years, taking hourly GPS locations. Even while we're here in the field, we can start to see the data coming through. Is there something that emerges from all of that information? Is there a story there that will actually inform future conservation decisions?
Myanmar is still 60% covered by forests. So this is a really good time to be here and to be working with elephants in this ecosystem.